there's nothing wrong with being an honest person. I like you even more now.
I'm not honest. I'm not honest. I'm just bad at lying.
Oh, yeah. Fair enough. Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, that's slightly different. Hi, I'm Gina. I'm here with Sharon Horgan, and these are Netflix Nine. Okay, so the premise of Criminal, I think, is great in that it's like we as viewers are watching through a screen, police watching criminals through a screen get interrogated.
There was a time I felt about joining the police force.
Why didn't you?
Oh, God. Why does anyone do anything?
My crime fighting days were over before they'd even begun. You'd be relieved to hear. Won't be taking your job just yet.
What draws you more, I guess, to this kind of role as opposed to a comedy?
I think just that, just like it felt like doing something different, you know. I've known Jim Field Smith, the director, for years and years and years, like from way, way back in the day when we when I got one of my first comedy jobs. So he sent me some clips from the previous season. It just felt like a interesting thing to spend 5 days doing. I really like the cast, you know, I'm big fans of all the cast.
Is there like a genre of TV or film that you either haven't touched or don't get to do as much of that you would like to do more of in the future?
I kind of love all of it. I'm always like, I want to play a cop. I want to do action. I mean, I've sort of done, I'm about to do a film. There's loads of action in it and have done in the past. And, you know, I mean, I love period drama, but I don't really have a period-y face. Not really.
What's a period-y face?
You know, like some people have those. I mean, I do, you know, a few days a month, but.
Would you say that you are better at lying yourself or noticing when someone else is lying?
100% noticing when someone else is lying.
Oh, really? You're not a good liar.
Not really. I kind of, it's the reason why I can notice when someone else is lying. I give too much detail. We did this thing in Catastrophe once where I was lying about where I was going to rob. And I said I was going to be on the South Bank watching chamber music with Melissa. And it was just too much detail. I could have just gone, I'm out with Melissa. And so anytime I'm sort of caught lying in real life, I say, I'm on the South Bank watching chamber music with Melissa.
Okay. You know, there's this, I don't know if you've ever heard of it. There's this test that it's like the Q test, where you can tell whether you're a good liar or a bad liar by drawing a Q on your forehead. Have you ever heard of this?
No.
Okay, draw a Q now on your forehead, like a capital Q on your forehead now. Yeah. The stalk of the Q on your left eyebrow or your right eyebrow?
I did it on this one, my right eyebrow.
Okay, yeah, you're a bad liar. Because because the premise is like, if you draw it to your left eyebrow, which means you've drawn it in a way that other people can see it, so you're more attuned to how people perceive you, and so you're better at lying because you know how people are going to be aware of you. And if you drew it the cue so it's facing you, yeah, then you're a bad liar. That's the theory behind it. I didn't make it up, so don't drag me in the comments. Okay, no need to tell me like your deepest, darkest secret, but I am curious, what do you most commonly lie about?
Reasons why I can't meet someone. I hate people who cancel meetings or get-togethers or, and I don't know why I can't just say I can't be arsed.
I make a lot of excuses for why I don't go out. I wish I could just be like, I don't want to. I really don't.
It's going to be even worse now after lockdown because everyone is so used to not going out that I think everyone's kind of settled into it a little bit more than they thought they would. And now going out doing anything, I'm like, can I be all right?
And you don't really have an excuse for everyone.
No.
Everyone knows you're going to be at home.
There you go.
Okay, so flipping it to the other side, if you were the interrogating party in the criminal scenario, right, what would you do to get people to tell the truth? And are you more of a good cop or a bad cop?
I don't give much away on my face when you meet me first, apparently. So having that skill makes me think maybe bad cop, because I can hide behind a sort of quite a scary demeanor. But then on the other hand, I'm Irish and chatty, and you know, I might make you a cup of tea and reel you in that way.
I wanted to speak a little bit about your Instagram, because you seem to be the busiest person on earth. Your bio said, I just wanted to make sure I don't get it wrong, right? It says writer, actor, producer, director and hand model. I'll come back to the hand model in a minute. Given really you are
not.
The truth,
the state of them. They're like,
no, your hands are great. They're great. No. So given you are a true jack of all trades, you've done so many amazing things. What do you actually do to relax, like when you have downtime?
Watch TV, go to the cinema, walk. I really like walking. Like yesterday I walked 2.5 miles to meet a friend for one drink and walk 2.5 miles back.
I just wanted to ask if you could elaborate on your role as a hand model. I want to know the truth. What's the truth, Sharon?
There is no truth. It's actually a joke between myself and my little sister. She has beautiful hands, but you know, they're not hand model hands. Hand model hands are ridiculous. They're like tiny, soft little, you know, you can't do anything with them because you can't sort of damage them in any way. You have to walk around with gloves and just keep them raised above your head all the time. And it's just been a sort of ongoing joke that we both would like to, we always felt we had hand modeling to fall back on. But as the years pass, your hands get gnarlier. I'm full veins. I mean, they're really behaving today. I don't know why, but normally they're like pulsing with veins.
No, if you're actually writing an autobiography, but if you were to do so, what would you call it? And what would this chapter of your life be called?
Oh my God, Gina.
Sorry.
These are too hard. It's the morning. What would I call my autobiography? I have no idea. I think titles are so hard. I'm thinking up things on the spot is even harder. So I don't know is the answer. I think this particular chapter of my life would have to get into the whole lockdown, or you know, I recently turned 50, and that made me sort of think I need to make some changes. You know, I need to work out what I want to spend this time doing.
That was a hard question. I'm sorry about that. May I suggest though, Britain's Best Hand Model? I don't know, just put it, one of them.
I'll put it in my notebook.
You've spoken in other interviews about living with your two daughters. So being that you've been living with two young people during lockdown, have you discovered TikTok? I'm dying to know this.
Yes, of course. Yeah. Okay. But not for me. I mean, if I went on TikTok, they'd both just leave. They'd pack their bags and leave. But occasionally I find I'll turn around and I'm in a TikTok because they are recording me. I mean, it's kind of funny, so I go for it. But
have you learned any of the TikTok dances? Like the din?
No, I really, really, really can't. I have no coordination whatsoever. It's an affliction. So no, I genuinely can't move in time to do anything.
Okay, here's my final question. I promise it's not that hard. No, it's not. Being that you're award-winning actor, director, creator, writer, everything, amazing. If you weren't doing any of those things, you could do anything else, but you could get paid the same amount of money. Anything else in the world, what would you be doing? Anything.
Wow. God. Traveling, maybe. Traveling, not like sort of reviewing hotels or anything like that, but if I could just be paid to travel around the world, I mean, with my daughters, and they weren't complaining, if I could pay them to come with me, use some of the money, that would be, I mean, I'd only want to do it for a few years, but that would be really nice. You know, the way you like always put off doing stuff like that because, you know, life and work and family and all that kind of thing. It'd be really nice to just go, well, no, I'm being paid to do this, so I'm just gonna skedaddle.
Okay, Sharon, I think our time here has ended. Aww. For your Netflix 9. Thank you so much.